So the book that I'm going to give for Christmas to basically all of my friends, vegetarian or not, is The Green Roasting Tin. A good vegetarian cookbook is basically the holy grail of every vegetarian's life, and you find a good one maybe every 5 years or so. But to find one that's the food's incredible in and really exciting and different and not just risottos and salads, but also one that is really easy and everything's really straightforward. I know that all my vegetarian friends are going to be incredibly grateful to find this under their Christmas tree.
The book I normally give at Christmas to everyone is Wilkie Collins' A Woman in White, and that's because it is just such a completely engrossing, spooky, eerie, mysterious Victorian novel that I think anyone can lose themselves in over Christmas. But I'm also thinking in the future I might give this, because Men Without Women is the perfect short story collection by a complete master of the trade, and you can literally run away from your family for 20 minutes at a time and lose yourself in this, and then come back refreshed and ready to face family.
So what book will you be gifting this Christmas?
So every year I give my dad a Jane Espo book, and this year he's going to get the new one, which is Macbeth. And it's a brilliant retelling of Shakespeare's classic, but Joe Nesbo's Macbeth, he's an ex-drug addict, he is a cop, and it's got all the thrills and tension of the original, but it's set in the contemporary world, full of police corruption and the dark, murky goings-on of the drugs trade.
So sadly I couldn't give this book at earlier Christmases because it was only published this year, but I will be giving Sarah Cooper's How to Be Successful Without Hurting Men's Feelings to every woman in my life. It is wickedly funny, and it's a very tongue-in-cheek look at workplace sexism. It's just the perfect gift for anyone who's ever been interrupted or mansplained to or asked to make the tea, which I sadly think is possibly every woman that I know.
It's a fantastic, powerful new book of poetry from a hot young wordslinger from South London, I believe, by the name of Jamie Coleman, and it is What I Lick Before Your Face and Other Haikus by Dogs. It's a art work as much as it is a book of poetry, combining powerful imagery with the traditional Japanese form of poetry, and it runs the gamut and covers a whole range of subjects. Politics, the lead, you make me bring you this harness of oppression in my own damn mouth. Food, toilet, I have a complaint. Someone keeps leaving huge poos in my special bowl. And philosophy, going to live on the farm. Guys, there is no farm. I wish there was, but there is only nothingness. I believe this will be up for all of the poetry prizes in 2019, and I recommend it very highly indeed. It's What I Lick Before Your Face and Other Haikus by Dogs.
So this Christmas, I'll be gifting this gorgeous paperback edition of Jeanette Winterson's Christmas Days. Look how gorgeous
it is.
So
nice.
It's absolutely beautiful. So the jacket works as like a full piece of, and it's basically like the front, the back, the spine. I just want to show you guys the pudding. It looks amazing. So it all just works together as this kind of fabulous Christmas treat. Jeanette Winterson offers us 12 stories and 12 recipes for the 12 days of Christmas, all topped and tailed with an introduction and a Christmas message. What's so special about this collection are the recipes inside. So we have recipes from Jeanette Winterson's family. So we have her dad's sherry trifle. We also have recipes from her friends. So we have the late Ruth Rendell's red cabbage, and also they all are quite traditional. So we also have Camilla Shamsie's turkey biryani,
which sounds amazing.
Have you ever had turkey biryani?
I haven't, no, have you?
Never had turkey biryani, so maybe that's what we'll be getting up to.
Yeah,
exactly, we'll be cooking that this year. So yeah, I'll definitely be gifting this. Also, we have a Christmassy tailored author bio from Jeanette Winterson herself, and I just wanted to read you a few lines because I think it is perfect. Jeanette Winterson has invented her own traditions for a happy Christmas and believes that anyone can. It's not about money, it's about imagination. Her advice is this: go for a walk with a flask of coffee and a piece of Christmas cake in your pocket. Think about the good things in your life and in the world. No bad things on this walk. Then come home, light the candles, sing the carols, and have yourself a merry little Christmas time.
This is maybe an unlikely choice for a Christmas present, but I'm going to talk about it anyway. It is Eileen by Atessa Mushfeg, a
dark, twisted literary thriller, which was nominated, which was shortlisted for the Man Booker Prize in 2016. It's steeped in black comedy, and it follows probably the most hypnotically revolting, weird character I've ever read in fiction. Eileen is a very lonely, friendless young woman, but her life changes when she meets a new colleague at work, and she becomes completely obsessed with befriending this woman, and the new friendship sucks her into this awful situation where she may be involved in a very serious crime. And the first half of the book, you are just completely absorbed in this very strange character, and then the plot just picks up and you are feverishly turning the pages trying to work out what's going to happen to her and what she's going to do. I absolutely love it, and everyone I've ever given to it to loves it as well. I think it's perfect for fans of Killing Eve because it's got that creepy obsessive dynamic between two female characters. So if you know anyone who loved Killing Eve and is looking for the next fix, then this is perfect for them. It's not for the faint-hearted, but don't be too shy to suggest it.
So the book I'll be giving everyone I know this Christmas is The Female Persuasion by Meg Wolitzer. Meg Wolitzer is one of my favourite writers. She is an absolutely underrated giant of fiction, and this book couldn't be more timely. It's about a college student who is mentored by a real queen of the feminist movement, and it's about their relationship as it unfolds, and it really is just brilliant. It's about feminism and Me Too and what it is to be young, and I really would recommend it to everyone.
So the book that I give at Christmas isn't one book, really. I have a few people that I love that I don't see very often who are book readers, so I tend to pack up a few nice hardbacks into a case and send it off. But often I'm giving a Murakami. So this Christmas, I'm sure, partly because the Murakami lovers are devoted people, and also because the books are beautiful, so they make good presents. So this year it will be Killing Commendatore. I'm a Murakami pusher, I think, and this will be the one for this year. But the book I probably give most often is this one, which is called A Little Aloud, and it's an anthology of poems and short stories and excerpts from novels to which are meant for reading aloud. And there's things in here for times when you're in love, and there's things in here for times when you want something scary, and there's things in here for reading at Christmas. And it's all proceeds from it go to an organisation called The Reader, which is all about getting great writing into the hands of people who need it, which is pretty much everyone. And it's for bringing people together, but also for reading by yourself.